We're all ready to start our 2020 Why Not Great Lakes Grand Tour boating season, or are we? Okay, so there's already going to be a little date panel. I took a short video of all the snow this morning, and
okay.
in my mind's eye, there's the date is going to be at the bottom of that.
Okay.
So yeah, they'll know that this was recorded on April the 3rd, 2020.
So like, what are we doing? We're sitting here in our house and it's snowing, and we're trying to find something to do, like everybody else.
Yeah.
With a smile on our face.
With a smile on our face. I mean, I think we're just like about everybody else in this country right now, where you're under some kind of mandate from state or a county or a city, and out here in Denver we're kind of socked in with all three. There are state orders, there's a Jefferson County order, and then a municipality we live in, there's another order to stay put, and we're being good citizens and we're staying put in our house, which is kind of like what we always did anyway. So this is no big change for us. I mean,
Christmas time to get jobs done, projects done, in my case, get taxes done, and
yep.
We hunker down this time of year anyway.
Right, and there's always gardening to do, and lawn work, you know, yard work to do, which is always my favorite. Sprinkler systems to get fixed. But the big thing for me is always getting ready for the next cruising season.
Right.
This is what I've always do at this time of the year. I make a big deal out of March 1st being, in my mind, the start of the cruising season. And I love March 1st. March 1st is kind of like, I'm free. I can start going crazy and planning.
So you did that some.
I did that some. I actually got all of the cruise planning and itineraries and all that kind of stuff all arranged for this cruising season up through us getting to Lake Erie. You know, we left Winter Harbor up in New York and down there, Oswego Canal. And then we were going to, from East Oswego, we were going to cross Lake Ontario to Kingston, then go to Trenton, then go to Cobourg, then over to Rochester. And then we were going to go from Rochester up to, I think we had one more stop on the New York side, and then we were going to go to Port Welland, which is the northern point of the Welland Canal. They were going to go through the Welland Canal to Point Colburn, which is on the southern end. That's in Canada. And I had gotten us there. I made the routes. I figured the timing. And that's including us taking the RV to St. Louis and spending several weeks in St. Louis, because that was a whole component about planning this cruise season that was really exciting, is they were adding an RV to it. I was really excited about that, you know, driving from here to St. Louis, spending time in St. Louis, and then driving up to Lake Erie and Lake Ontario. And I was really looking forward to that a lot. Doesn't mean it's not going to happen. It still can, but it's going to be in some different form. It's either going to be, we're either going to cut wholesale chunks out, or we're just going to do the whole thing, but really abbreviated and really quickly. We have to decide what we want to do with that yet. But so I've been in full planning mode, and all of a sudden this COVID-19 coronavirus thing hits, and everything I've done is obsolete. You know?
No, I don't think that.
Well, it's
it'll be different.
It'll be different. You know, it's going to be a different cruise plan than what we had originally imagined and thought it was going to be like. And that's too bad. It was going to be a nice cruise plan too, because it was going to be kind of leisurely. We were going to spend big chunks of time at several different places, which is unusual for us. We're usually on the move, and so things are different this year. And you know, we're concerned about the virus and the outbreak and all that kind of stuff. And it impacts a lot of people far worse than it's impacting us. You know, there's a lot of tragedy, and there's a lot of very unhappy people, and there's a lot of scared people. And but I guess my whole point of view I'm taking is, you know, keep calm, keep going, you know, just don't stop. But you just, you know, we do have to modify our behaviors, and we do have to modify what our plans are. And I mean, I've even broken it down to what I think the five reasons are, the five things that I'm looking at to, holding up 10 fingers, talking about five things. The five things that we need to look at as far as what's going to affect the cruise plan. And you know, I'm in full analytical mode here, so just bear with me on this. Number one are all the mandates on closures here in Colorado. You know, it was interesting. We did go out yesterday for a little while to go visit a friend of ours, and it looked like business as usual to me. You know, as far as traffic goes and stuff like that. So I'm kind of wondering who's following the rules here. It doesn't seem like anybody is. But rules are in place right now, so we are going to stick with it. We're going to do our part. The second point that's really important is the mandates and rules and orders in New York State, because the boat is at a marina in New York State. And if any state is clamping down on activity and unnecessary businesses and non-essential businesses and things like that, it's New York. We know for a fact that Winter Harbor at this point is closed, which they would be anyway because it's not the season yet. But even during the off season, they were staffed because they were doing repairs and they were doing, you know, repairing boats and making modifications to boats. And their office is closed. There's nobody on the site at all. They were saying someone is going there once a day to check on things. And it's probably Tom, the owner, because he lives on the property. But there's nobody there. So it's a whole different way. So it's not just a seasonal closure. It's closed. So we don't know when that's all going to be lifted, because New York's in very serious shape with the whole outbreak and all that. The third part about this is the whole interruption to the marine infrastructure that exists. Marinas are closed. Is there going to be a pump out? Are the locks and canals going to be open? We know for a fact that the St. Lawrence Seaway canals, including the Welland Canal and locks, are closed to recreational traffic. You know, their message is suspended until further notice. Who knows when that is? And we don't even know what the status of the Erie and the Oswego canals are. We know they're scheduled to open.
It's been announced that I know of.
They're scheduled to open on May 14th, but that's all they're saying right now. So we don't know what's going on there. And then the other reason is that they're talking about high water again. So we got to deal with those issues again. So, I mean, that's a totally, you know, different thing. And I think I said there's five reasons. I can only think of four. I know there's a fifth. I've been thinking about this, but let's see, wait a minute. Mandates here, mandates in New York, infrastructure disruption, high water. Oh, yeah. And the fifth reason is because we've had some can't-miss meetings planned for April and early May, and then our whole thinking was get those done, load up the RV, get out of town. Well, now, you know, we've been told by several of these that these are pushed off until early June. So, you know, that delays us leaving Denver as it is. However, none of these things, none of these possible outcomes are deal breakers in my mind. Because if you think about last year, we really didn't leave to go cruising until after the 4th of July. In early June, we did leave the marina and we went to Rochester and we spent a month in Rochester. And then we decided, because we were apprehensive about going because of the high water levels and the heavy currents and stuff like that. We waited until after the 4th of July and then we screwed it. We went, we decided, let's go. And we had a great time. It was a great season and we had plenty of time. And what was really interesting is that we ended up boating past the end of the cruising season in Canada. There was nobody out there. I mean, when we came down the Rideau Canal from Ottawa to Kingston, we were by ourselves. It was wonderful. And the weather was fabulous. It was warm, it was comfortable, it was pleasant, it was nice. It was just great boating conditions, just wonderful. So I'm okay with that. So nothing is a deal breaker so far. The question is this going to be, you know, are municipalities, provinces, states, and countries going to over reach on preventative measures of this cropping up again in the fall, which it probably will. The other big consideration that I think of too is, what's it going to be like going back and forth between the United States and Canada? Yeah, Canada's borders are closed right now. The United States borders are closed right now. Does that affect vessel passage? You know, we're part of the, what's the card?
Nexus.
We have Nexus cards. Does this affect Nexus access to borders? So those are big unanswered questions.
Will they continue to affect?
Yes.
Into the months of July and August, for instance?
Correct.
Nobody knows the answer to that.
Like, for instance, if we can't go into Canada, okay, our choices are basically Rochester.
Or Rochester.
Or Oswego. Or we go to the St. Lawrence Seaway and we go out to Alexandria Bay or something like that. Okay. You know, Clayton and Alexandria Bay. You know, not much going on because you can't get to Lake Erie unless you're going to Canada. And you can't go any further on the St. Lawrence Seaway than really Alexandria Bay because that's in Canada. So that's where you're...
We gotta cross the border sometime.
We gotta go into Canada sometime. You know, we can't go over to Kingston. We can't go to Cobourg. We can't go to Trenton. We can't go to a lot of... You know, we couldn't even drive to Canada.
Right.
Yeah.
Wouldn't matter.
So, I mean, that's a big question too. Can we get into Canada? So anyway, so it's a very complicated situation and one that, you know, we're going to have to pay attention to the news. We're going to have to stay on top of things. And I guess of all those considerations, the one I'm most concerned about that is going to be a more of a deal breaker than anything else is the whole infrastructure thing. I'm particularly concerned about marinas, you know, going out of business because they have to be closed by the state of New York and there's no pump out. You lose pump out capability. You know, Winter Harbor, fortunately, is a pretty robust, heavy duty marina. You know, and they have pump out and you know, I think they're fine. But I think about, you know, the Oswego marina where we stay down in Oswego. That's kind of a flimsy operation.
We have no idea.
We have no idea. So, I mean, it's going to be a real challenge. So, you know, I'm constantly trying to stay prepared, at least mentally, so that, you know, at least I do have the first half of it planned. I don't have it calendared out. I don't have it.
Can't
yet. Yeah, so if we knew we were leaving on such and such date, you know, I can quickly put that into motion. And then there's I keep digging a deeper hole here. But then there's a whole thing. There's going to be a lot of looper boats in the Great Lakes, probably.
Given this, I wonder if anybody who didn't stop there last fall would even have tried to go north. Like, we have some friends who, their boats actually at Winter Harbor, they were actually going to go to Chesapeake
right.
in the spring, and have already decided that's not going to happen.
Right.
So I would guess that even if there were people who maybe weren't aware of the Illinois closures or had other plans and were seriously going to keep doing loop this 2020-21, I don't even think they'll start more.
No.
They might get to Chesapeake and stay and go back to Carolina.
Right.
Or they might get to, you know, wherever. If they're starting on the southern side,
right.
Kentucky Lake side,
right.
and they just stay south. I think most of the marinas in the north who would normally count on looper traffic, I think they've written off this year that nobody's coming north to begin with.
Yeah.
I doubt if you're going to find it any busier than we did last year, because I don't even think they're heading north.
I certainly hope the traffic keeps up because there's a lot of businesses depend on brokers and stuff like
that.
This
was going to be a tough year anyway because of the Illinois law.
You bet it was. Anyway, it's going to be an interesting spring, you know, and hopefully we do get the season underway. Like I said, it's certainly going to be different than what I originally planned, but fortunately I'm pretty darn good at this planning stuff, so I can you know, I can pick up where we left off and we can move forward with this as move forward with the season in some form or fashion. Anyway, it will be fun. I mean, I'm looking forward to the whole RV, you know, boat thing. I really am. And what's the term? Surf and turf? You know, it's a real surf and turf kind of thing. But because the RV is ready to go. It is ready to go. I mean, all we have to do is load it up, get out.
We actually took it in, was it February?
February, middle of February.
Way, way, way early.
Yep.
To have a couple things checked, and that became additional solar panels and batteries and
right.
Upgraded a number of things. So right. It really is boondocking kind of ready.
It's ready to go.
And now, when everybody would normally be going to the RV place, and you couldn't get an appointment.
Yeah, couldn't get an appointment to save your life. Yeah.
Until October.
Yep.
You know, we avoided all that. So if we could go out and even do, I don't know, maybe we do 4 months of RVing this year and 1.5 months of boating.
Yep.
It just get flopped a little bit.
Well, see, that's the other thing that confuses me is that the RV, you know, in the states, like in New York, and a lot of the states that have mandated closures, they're even closing RV campgrounds.
Well, that's what I wondered. Have you checked on those
yes.
kind of things? That's the same as marinas. They're
yep.
all, yeah. Well, people are congregating, even though it's outside.
Yeah.
People are near and grouping together and so forth.
Anyway, that's my story and sticking to it. I'm going to stay prepared. I'm going to be ready. And as soon as we
we're going to have some kind of summer.
We're gonna have some kind of summer. Yes, we're gonna have some kind of summer. But as soon as we get a green light to go, we're gone. Please make sure you like, comment on, and share this video, and subscribe to this channel. Also, link to me on Facebook and Instagram. Links are in the description. One last thing, all of my content can be found by searching hashtag SkipperDaryl everywhere. Oh yeah, watch these two videos also. Thanks a lot.